Hello friends, in this video I'm going to install the Laravel role and permission package from the Spotty team. So here we have, and if you go to the documentation inside the spotty.b docs Laravel permission, installation in Laravel, and we need to copy this command here, go to the terminal. I am inside the movie app. Okay, paste that in, enter. Also, we need to add the provider. So copy, and inside the config app PHP, we need to add that. So in the VS Code, open the app.php, set the config, and down, we have the providers, and here I'm going to add the Spotty permission service provider. It's saved. Also, if you want the vendor publish, copy and paste that. Okay, next thing is the run. Optimize clear. And now we need to migrate the, and it's going to create permissions table. We have only one user. Inside the roles, we have roles, we have role has permission table, we have permissions, model has a role, and model has permission. Okay. Now you go to the basic usage, and we need to add the as roles trait in the user model. So go to the VS Code, user model, and here use as roles and import that. Hit save and close. Now we can create a role by say role and create, but I'm going to create a role using artisan commands and copy that code php artisan permission create a role and the name. I'm going to paste it here, and I'm going to create role for the user and one for the admin. Okay. And in the basic usage, we have a blade directives. And here is how you can use for the permission or for the role. We can say role and the name, and here we can add what we want to show only to the user who has this role. Okay, for that I'm going to do is here we have the drop down for the profile and logout. I'm going to add one more for the admin, and we need to go inside the resources, views, components, and header. Here we have a profile link. I'm going to copy that and paste and create one more for the admin. And also the route is going to be admin.index. And we need to create that. So open the web PHP inside the routes and copy this one, paste in, and say admin here. but I'm not going to return the view right now, so I'm going to return a string. It's going to say admin array and hit save. Now if I refresh here, admin index, okay, we need to give it a name here, name admin dot index, save, and now refresh. Yeah, we have a drop down, and if I click, we go to the admin and we have the admin array here. Okay, now how we can show this only to the admin user, we can use the role delete directive. So role and the name, in our case is admin, and the role, and hit save. Now refresh, we don't see the role because we are not admin. For that, I'm going to assign a role to this user. Because we are in the dashboard now, here, before I'm going to say auth user assign role admin, hit save, and now refresh here. Yeah, if I click, now we see the admin because we are now admin. If I open the database and model has roles, yeah, we see we have one record, role ID is 2, and model type is user, and model ID is 1. Okay, if I log out here, and also I'm going to remove that line to not just assign to another user that one. So fake filler, register, and now if I click, we don't see the admin link here, but we can navigate to the admin by clicking there, and we can visit. So to protect that, we need to use the middleware, and here we have using middleware in our app. We can add the role middleware, but if you want, you can add permission and role or permission. I'm going to add them all. So copy, go to the VS Code and open the kernel PHP in the root middleware, paste that one and save. And now here I need to add I'm going to add them before. So copy this one and paste it here. And here I'm going to say role and the name of the role, admin in our case. Go here now, and if I refresh, oh, we have 403. User does not have the right roles. If I go back and change the user, log out and log in as admin. Okay, now if I go to the admin, yeah, we can see. Okay, friends, that is for this video. Hope you enjoy and see you in the next one. All the best.